Bob, why Garland? Why now?
I think it's a fitting time to return my game. I haven't swung a club in 4 years. I look forward to going directly to the tee box with no practice swing whatsoever.
Is this your trainer loosening you up?
Yep. He's actually my chirotherapist. It's a new position.
Okay.
His primary objective is to keep my pods loose,
okay,
which allows me to bring the club back,
okay,
in full swing. So I'm looking forward to the weekend.
Good.
I haven't golfed in 4 years.
He should do pretty well this weekend.
Okay.
I anticipate maintaining the same score that I've always been able to play, about 120.
Okay.
So I'm looking forward to the tee box.
Okay, we'll see you out there.
Thanks.
So tell me, what are your thoughts on the course today?
Well, we have an hour before the round starts, and staying with my commitment to have no warm-ups while the rest of the team is warming up at the range, I'll be in watching Andy Griffith reruns. So I got about an hour to kill. I've just been exposed. They did find the half a honey baked ham in my bag, which is not allowed on the course, but I'm going to try and negotiate a settlement.
Now, you're not going to stretch either, right? That's correct? No stretching, no nothing?
Nothing. No, not even... but a simple address of the ball. No backswing, no swaggle. You set the ball, and you bring it back, and you tee off.
All right. You know, you've signed the contract that we can film it with high-speed video.
Yep.
And that you've, you know...
You'll need it.
Yeah.
Especially to keep the track of the spin on the ball.
Okay. Now, you do some things with the club head face during the backswing, isn't that right?
Yeah, one of the things I like to do is, in the backswing, most golfers will break their wrist.
Yes.
I tend to roll the club in my hand, so the club does one rotation, and then as it comes through 360, it's square back on the ball.
I see.
For a square shot.
And what does that give you in terms of wrist action and the backswing?
What it does is it keeps the pressure off the back of the wrist and allows the intercostal muscles behind the pods to really come through the ball, because I'm incapable of rotating my hips. So it's a compensation, because given the shoulders, when I'm full back, I can no longer see the ball. So I have one of my hats I don't have with me. There's actually a little mirror in the hat.
I see.
So
okay.
As I'm back, I can look here and see down at the ball, which allows me to rotate, square, and then drive.
But what I had done with this hat with the mirror in it,
yeah,
I put crosshairs in it.
Yeah. Now you're his trainer, medical advisor, and Matt. Now this is Max. Max, yep. You're kind of sort of his coach, right?
Yeah.
Could you step into the picture? I'd like for Dr. Livernoy to sort of explain his footwork, too.
I'm the doctor. He's the golfer.
That's what I meant. I'd like for Bob to show us what he does.
Bob, remember to tell him about the crosshair. Okay, sorry.
Golfers tend to slice or hook the ball.
Let me zoom in on your feet so that we can because this, as I understand it, this is the real key to distance for you.
Yeah, but the rotation, since the hips don't move,
right?
There's the tibial plateau,
right?
And it's the three tibias.
Tri-tibial.
It's called the tri-tip.
Now that was discovered when you broke your ankle years ago. They took the X-ray and saw the third bone.
No, I actually have three bones below the knee.
Okay.
And I'm incapable of. The only way I can rotate really is if I come back on my heels and actually turn.
Right, but it's toe action. See, the bottom of his shoes don't have bottoms in it.
Okay.
And the bottom of the toes grab. We don't use spikes, and the toes go.
Yeah.
That's how he rotates.
You see.
Get my smoke out of the picture.
There's no hip rotation.
Could you show us again how the toes do that? I wanted to make sure we got a close-up of that.
Well, you see, what I did during the surgery is that we made him, hold on a minute, made him special shoes. We cut the bottoms out of the shoes. He doesn't have them on yet. But his toes grip.
Yeah.
Into the turf.
And then when he makes his rotation, the toes do this to rotate his body, and then he follows through. Yep. That took some real major, rerouting muscles and nerve endings, but
what was the alternative? No golf, right?
No golf.
Yep.
Yeah.
Bowling, which is purely a perpendicular.
Well,
board.
Bob, walk us through your feet work, okay? Before we get to the tee.
Depending on the weather, the conditions. If I'm slicing it, I tend to put a wedge under my left foot.
Okay.
It keeps me back off the ball.
Got it.
If I'm hooking it, the wedge goes under here.
Okay.
And sometimes I end up with both, wedges under both, so I hit it straight.
Ah, okay.
Right.
Yep. Well, we'll be curious to see what strategy you use today.
Looking forward to it.
But also include, now in the video, if you're out there video while we're out on the course, if he gets a bad lie on a hillside or whatever, he'll use the 1, 1A, 2, 2A, and 3B wedges to compensate for the hillside.
Now, for the I just remembered when I was preparing for this interview, you had to get a PGA exemption for your ankle and feet wedges, right?
Yeah, in fact, they had to submit x-rays.
To prove.
And they used, Ali's doctor. Pacheco?
Ferdy Pacheco, the fight doctor.
Well, actually verified the bone structure.
Yeah, I had him at my office, and then I sent him over. Didn't we scan him?
Yeah, we scanned and sent him over.
Okay,
so
all right.
That's the only way they would grant the exemption.
Okay.
And they found it to really be no real advantage to the game. So.
Okay, all right.
Bob, you're looking tight again. Come on.
Yep. Going to loosen me up. All right, we're ready.
All right, well, thank you for your time. We'll look forward to seeing you on the tee.
Thanks. Thank you, too.
Doctor, thank you very much.
Thanks.
Max, thanks for your input.
No problem.
All right.
Yeah, Coach, come over here. Got to say goodbye now. Thanks. Right. Tell him to say thanks.
Thank you.
Thank you.
A lot. Good job, guys.
Come on.
Thank you.
Get your money out.
I notice that you're not swinging. Could you fill us in again?
The game of golf's founded on how few strokes you can play. So I've subscribed to the philosophy, don't do any before the round. For me, it's a jinx. So I do not take any warm-ups, nor do I take any even practice swings. As you'll see when I tee off today, I'll simply set the ball, address it, and swing with not even a backswing. It's just consistent with my philosophy of, it's a low preparation philosophy.
I see.
So, just enjoying a Diet 7-Up and some cashews, waiting for the round.
Thank you. We'll look forward to the tee shot. So I noticed that the cover's not off your bag yet. What's the situation?
One of the things that tortures a lot of novice golfers is which club to play. You get out in the middle of the fairway, you're having difficulty judging the distance. So what I like to do before the round, I don't even peek in the bag.
Then what you're saying is you really don't know what clubs you have with you.
No, in fact, I have club heads similar to this, head covers. I just grab the club and go and compensate once I'm addressing the ball.
So are you saying then, on the record, that it doesn't really matter what club you use, you can adjust in your backswing?
Not from the tee box, no, because with the rotation, if in the rotation when I go from the mirror to the club face, if I sense it's a 5-wood, I just know to pick up the speed of the swing. Because the faster I swing, the farther the ball goes.
You know, excuse me for saying this, Dr. Livernai, but that's quite remarkable.
Mm-hmm. It's called adaptational golf.
Ah, okay.
So really, the club selection is irrelevant, especially from the first tee.
Does anyone teach that at any of the great places? Or
it's unteachable. It's purely instinctive, and as you'll see when we get to the tee box, I'll merely grab a club and go.
Okay, well, we're looking forward to it. Thanks.
Yep. See what I can grab?
2-wood.
Yep, 2-wood. 2-wood magic.
So what's the background on this shot? This is the first time you've touched the club in 4 years or 3 years?
4 years. This wood is Falcata wood.
Okay.
Comes from the Philippines, and when you hit the ball, it'll make a certain noise. It goes, Falcata. You'll hear that sound.
I got one.
So beware. So McGregor 2-wood.
Nice and dense from the cool temperatures.
Yep, the cool temperature is a nice dense wood. And you'll see back here, what you would think is just healing the ball. That's actually grooved that way for aerodynamic follow through on the club.
Now that goes to your club speed. That's the design, actually. Okay.
You'll see it in action.
So what ball are you hitting today?
Courtesy of usedgolfballs.com, I'm hitting a Top Flight Mint Condition XL 3000.
All right, and do you have a tee?
Yes, I'm going to be playing the Super Feel. And I'll use this tee.
Okay. What's your tee? I took it from your bag.
Okay.
Thanks for your hospitality.
Okay.
Ready?
Let's go.
How often are we going to see you?
You just have to sort of ignore the sound, right?
On Michigan, 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 Illinois.
Steve, are we playing the tips or the blues?
The blues, Bob.
What?
The blues.
Okay, let's get somebody in the tee and go.
All right.
All right. Let's go.
All right, guys. No practice. No stretch. Oh, Illinois.
Okay, Does it go around the corner?
Yeah, it's straight out.
Thank you, I'll see you in a little bit.
Me and the guy in the blue.
Here we go. No practice, no swaggle, no backswing, just straight address of the ball, Bobby.
After 3 years.
Yes. Oh, no. Getting one in, two out, hitting three
from the other side of the water.
Call the catch.
Ooh, Jimmy! Wow. Fluid.
All right.
Nice shot.
Thank you.
Paul, try that drive.
Good shot, John.
All right, Dave, going for the green.
Yeah.
Remember, I only have 4 gigabytes in the memory, Davey. All right.
That's the idea. I sliced the hell out. I can't keep it.
It's going to work.
It actually turns the ball for you.
All right, gentlemen, take the markers when you go.
Hang on.
Water.
Paul.
Who's next?
Me.